I'm Victor Morgan, rector of St. Luke's Church, Blue Ridge, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to the service of evening prayer here in Blue Ridge, Georgia. We have with us in our live congregation the Reverend Ron Wigander, Jim Noblett, and at the organ, Eileen Kerr. And we're glad to know that you're with us by way of the internet. Tomorrow, there will be three options for worship on the third Sunday after Easter. The first option is in-church worship. This will be the first time in about 6 weeks that we have been able to come back into our church and actually have a living congregation, a full congregation. But we want to assure you that all the protocols, safe practices, are being put in place to ensure the health and safety of our worshipers tomorrow. But also, some will choose to continue the tradition we established about 6 weeks ago by remaining in their automobile. The service will continue to be broadcast over 98.1 and also may be viewed on Facebook live stream. That's the second option. And then the third option, of course, some of our friends are far away in other places, and we're glad to know you're with us as well. And we will continue to live stream our services, and then they will be put on to YouTube following the service. So whichever way you're planning to connect with us tomorrow, it is good to know that you will be with us. And we wish you a very blessed third Sunday in after Easter, and we look forward to seeing you tomorrow. We sing hymn 169, God that madest earth and heaven, darkness and light.
God that made us earth and heaven, darkness and light, who the day for toil has given, for rest the night. May thine angels guard, defend us, slumber
of thy house and the place where thine honor dwelleth. Dearly beloved brethren, the scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with an humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by his infinite goodness and mercy. And although we ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we most chiefly so to do when we assemble and meet together to render thanks for the great benefits we have received at his hands, to set forth his most worthy praise,
to hear his most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary, as well for the body as the soul. Wherefore I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying after me, Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And there is no help in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou those, O God, who confess their faults. Restore thou those who are penitent, according to thy promises to live in mankind, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen.
Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather that he may turn from his wickedness and live, hath given power and commandment to his ministers to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardoneth and absolveth all those who truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouth shall show forth thy praise.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
Psalms for the evening of the second day, beginning on page 355 in the Book of Common. Hear me, Lord, for there is not one godly man left. For the faithful are diminished from among the children of men.
They talk of vanity, every one with his neighbor. They do but flatter with their lips, and dissemble in their double heart.
The Lord shall root out all deceitful lips, and the tongue that speaketh proud things.
Which have said, with our tongue we will prevail. We are they that ought to speak. Who is the Lord over us?
Now for the comfortless trouble's sake of the needy, and because of the deep sighing of the poor,
I will up, saith the Lord, and will help every one from him that swelleth against him, and will set him at rest.
The words of the Lord are pure words, even as the silver which from the earth is tried and purified seven times in the fire.
Thou shalt keep them, O Lord. Thou shalt preserve them from this generation forever.
The ungodly walk on every side. When they are exalted, the children of men are put to rebuke.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning,
is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
How long wilt thou forget me, O Lord, forever? How long wilt thou hide thy face from me?
How long shall I seek counsel in my soul, and be so vexed in my heart? How long shall my enemies triumph over me?
Consider and hear me, O Lord my God. Lighten mine eyes, that I sleep not in death.
Lest mine enemies say, I have rebelled against him. For if I be cast down, they that trouble me will rejoice at it.
But my trust is in thy mercy, and my heart is joyful in thy salvation.
But I will sing of the Lord, because he hath dealt so lovingly with me. Yea, I will praise the name of the Lord most highest.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The fool hath said in his heart, there is no God.
They are corrupt and become abominable in their doings. There is none that doeth good, no, not one.
The Lord looked down from heaven upon the children of men to see if there were any that would understand and seek after God.
But they are all gone out of the way. They are altogether become abominable. There is none that doeth good, no, not one.
Have they no knowledge that they are all such workers of mischief, eating up my people as it were bread, and call not upon the Lord?
There were they brought in for great fear, even where no fear was. For God is in the generation of the righteous.
As for you, you have made a mock at the counsel of the poor, because he putteth his trust in the Lord.
Who shall give salvation unto Israel out of Zion? When the Lord turneth the captivity of his people, then shall Jacob rejoice, and Israel shall be glad.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Here beginneth the fifth verse of the 45th chapter of the book of the prophet Isaiah. I am the Lord, and there is none else. There is no God beside me. I girded thee, though thou hast not known me, that they may know from the rising of the sun and from the west that there is none beside me. I am the Lord, and there is none else. I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things. Drop down, ye heavens from above, and let the skies pour down righteousness. Let the earth open, and let them bring forth salvation, and let righteousness spring up together. I, the Lord, have created it. Woe unto him that striveth with his maker. Let the potsherd strive with the potsherds of the earth. Shall the clay say to him that fashioneth it, what makest thou? Or thy work, he hath no hands? Woe unto him that saith unto his father, what begettest thou? Or to the woman, what hast thou brought forth? Thus saith the Lord, the Holy One of Israel and his Maker, ask me of things to come concerning my sons, and concerning the work of my hands command ye me. I have made the earth and created man upon it. I, even my hands, have stretched out the heavens, and all their host have I commanded. Verily thou art a God that hidest thyself, O God of Israel, the Savior. They shall be ashamed and also confounded, all of them. They shall go to confusion together that are makers of idols. But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation. Ye shall not be ashamed, nor confounded, world without end. For thus saith the Lord that createth the heavens, God himself that formed the earth and made it. If he hath established it, he created it not in vain. He formed it to be inhabited. I am the Lord, and there is none else. I have not spoken in secret in a dark place of earth. I said not unto the seed of Jacob, seek ye me in vain. I, the Lord, speak righteousness. I declare things that are right. Look unto me, and be ye saved, all the ends of the earth. For I am God, and there is none else. Here endeth the first lesson.
The Magnificat, the Song of Mary. My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior.
For he hath regarded the lowliness of his handmaid.
For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed.
For he that is mighty hath magnified me, and holy is his name.
And his mercy is on them that fear him throughout all generations.
He hath showed strength with his arm. He hath scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts.
He hath put down the mighty from their seat, and hath exalted the humble and meek.
He hath filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he hath sent empty away.
He, remembering his mercy, hath opened his servant Israel, as he promised to our forefathers Abraham and his seed forever.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Here beginneth the sixth verse of the fifth chapter of the second epistle general of Peter. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Whom resisteth steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. But the God of grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after ye have suffered a while, make ye perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. By Silvanus, a faithful brother unto you, as I suppose, I have written briefly, exhorting and testifying that this is the true grace of God wherein ye stand. The church that is at Babylon, elected together with you, saluteth you, and so doth Marcus, my son. Greet ye one another with a kiss of charity. Peace be with you, all that are in Christ Jesus. Amen. Here ended the second lesson.
But Nunc Dimittis, the Song of Simeon. Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace according to thy word.
For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty.
From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O Lord, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the state.
And mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness.
And make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people.
And bless thine inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord.
For it is thou, Lord, only, that makest us dwell in safety.
O God, may clean our hearts within us.
And take not thy Holy Spirit from us.
Almighty God, who showest to them that are in error the light of thy truth, to the intent that they may return into the way of righteousness, grant unto all those who are admitted into the fellowship of Christ's religion that they may avoid those things which are contrary to their profession, and follow all such things as are agreeable to the same, through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsel, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thine only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Almighty God, whose kingdom is everlasting and power infinite, have mercy upon this whole land, and so rule the hearts of thy servants, the President of the United States, the Governor of this state, and all others in authority, that they, knowing whose ministers they are, may above all things seek thy honor and glory, and that we and all the people, duly considering whose authority they bear, may faithfully and obediently honor them according to thy blessed word and ordinance, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee and the Holy Ghost liveth and reigneth ever, one God, world without end.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, from whom cometh every good and perfect gift, send down upon our bishops and other clergy and upon the congregations committed to their charge the healthful spirit of thy grace, and that they may truly please thee, pour upon them the continual dew of thy blessing. Grant this, O Lord, for the honor of our advocate and mediator, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
O God, the creator and preserver of all mankind, we humbly beseech thee for all sorts and conditions of men, that thou wouldest be pleased to make thy ways known unto them, thy saving health unto all nations. More especially we pray for thy holy church universal, that it may be so guided and governed by thy good spirit, that all who profess and call themselves Christians may be led into the way of truth and hold the faith in unity of spirit, in the bond of peace, and in righteousness of life. Finally, we commend to thy fatherly goodness all those who are in any ways afflicted or distressed in mind, body, or estate, that it may please thee to comfort and relieve them according to their several necessities, giving them patience under their sufferings and a happy issue out of all their afflictions. And this we beg for Jesus Christ's sake.
Amen.
Almighty God,
Father of all mercies, we, thy unworthy servants, do give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We bless thee for our creation,
preservation in all the blessings of this life, but above all for thine inestimable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time, with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and dost promise if two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore.
Amen.